In this example, what we're doing is we have two dictionaries, and we're going to convert the dictionaries into a data frame. So in the first one, we have product ID, start, and store. We have a key value pair. The key is the ID, and the value is a list. And the list can have strings, dates, numbers. And then what you do is in Pandas data frame, there's an API called from underscore dict, D-I-C-T. And what that's saying is take the dictionary and convert that into a data frame. So what you could also have done if you, that's kind of like a condensed form. If you know, if you're assembling all this, I could have taken just this dictionary definition here and inserted it here instead of the data into the data frame itself. And it knows to, that it's a data frame type, and it automatically will convert the dictionary into the data frame. So that's one way to bypass having to call the API. But otherwise, you would call the API. Okay, next one. This is just kind of a simple one. This is our file. In astronomy, they do file format in FITS. And so what I did was I grabbed the file. It's in raw format. I used FITS to open it up, and then grab the image data, the first image, and then display it. So they just didn't know how to read this file format, and so I was able to figure that out and display it. So that's if you're dealing with astronomy data, this is how you import it, and then you use the zero index and they grab it and then you can show it. So it's kind of cool. So I don't know what this is, but it looks like it's some sort of nebula, and I'm able to grab that data and then display it. Okay, so next thing we're doing is we have a random generator. We seed the generator with the value, set the end value equal to 20. So we're gonna pull random number from n. So we have 20 random numbers. And then we'll have 20 zeros, and we'll get 20 random numbers and multiply that by 2 and subtract 0.5. And then we have 20 zeros. Then we'll take the data frame. So we have C2 and C4. So we'll take C2 equals C1 minus 3 times a random n. So it's basically just doing some randomization of numbers, and I'm putting it into a formula. Okay, then I'm going to create a couple of data frames using the copy. So I'll take column 1 and 2 and copy that into dfplot. And then I'll set cat equal to set 1, and then do the same thing with C2, C4, and then call that set 2. Then to the plot, I will append the DF temperature. So this would be the DF temperature. And then using a joint grid plot, take C1 and C2, and I'll do the regular plot and a scatter plot and a KD density plot. And in the margins, I'll have also a KD density plot. Okay, so we're about ready to take a look at that. So now I have my different categories, so I can do, I can look at set 1 and I can look at set 2. All right, so let's look at what this does. So here's set 1 using the joint plot, and you can see I've got my data, and then I've got a linear regression plot through the data, and then I can see the area of highest density. So using that KD density plot, I can see where this area right here is my highest density. And then here is the second set of random numbers and formula. And you can see then it used a little different algorithm. It didn't use a KD density. Let's see, what did we use? Set two. So it uses bin. So it used a histogram instead. All right. Well, I'll let you digest that and think about it. But this shows kind of how the value of joint plot and joint grid. So we have joint grid, and then we have joint plot, and then we have a second joint plot. So we can see the effect of joint grid, joint plot. Okay.